Thank you, guys. We move to the second part of the discussion. So we're going now to listen to the short talks from the colleagues working on these three remaining pillars. We have again four contributions, and we start with innovative balance of plant for fuel cell-based powertrain. And this will be presented by Andrea Barici.
Thank you. This is the pointer, is it?
Okay.
Thank you very much. So thank you. I'm presenting here this PhD activity that has been started in November. And the title is Innovative Balance of Plant for Fuel Cell-Based Powertrain. And it is done in collaboration with, it consists in a collaboration of three groups here at Politecnico di Milano to work on this nice new topic. So just to give a brief overview of the motivation of the work, I will not go into the technical details of the implementation of the work, but so what is nice to know now is that actually, I think 2 or 3 years ago, very little was known in the scientific literature regarding how fuel cell cars are really operated. Actually, all this information belonged to the automotive company and was kept very confidential. Recently, thanks to the Argonne National Lab and also to the fact that some hydrogen cars are now on the roads, some information is available. And what is actually immediately found from looking at this data is that the real operation of fuel cell cars is extremely dynamic. So if you see here, for example, in red, the power of the fuel cell stack, or in green, the power of the battery in such an hybrid configuration. And you see that you do not have really a steady state condition, because in here, all the temperature, relative humidities, flow rates are all changing. So this is a bit different from what we see in everyday lab life, where we actually test the fuel cells in steady state condition. And for example, we have all kind of curves like this, where we have the fuel cell system steady state efficiency or the system efficiency. For example, here is a car that is run in a steady state mode, so something that is really not really easy to understand. So what are the players behind these? Behind these, we have the fuel cell stack, which is own dynamics, depends on the materials, on the design of the components, and so on. We have the balance of plant that play a major role. So we have the humidification, the external humidification. We have the tank, we have the hydrogen recirculation system, we have the air compressor, all of them giving an input in the dynamics of the process. Then we have the operating strategy. So for example, the degree of hybridization of the vehicle. We know that the battery is much faster compared to the fuel cell power output. So for example, during the fast transient, the battery should cover all the peaks and will have a role in the regenerative braking and so on. And then we have external variables, which are basically we cannot control. So the role of the user, what kind of vehicle we are building, the ambient conditions, so external temperature, humidity, vibrations of the car. So in this kind of world, what we actually need to consider is that the overall system efficiency, which will change depending on the system power output, will not be anymore a line, but actually will be a kind of cloud, a region, where the efficiency will change. And in here, we have many points instantaneously, where the system is instantaneously working at many different temperature relative humidity because of the dynamics of the process itself. For sure, this map is constrained by some overall constraints that will come from all of the components that I already discussed. And the idea is, in this project, we will not much focus on the fuel cell material itself. That is a matter of those who develop new components or study catalysts and so on. But actually, we'll keep a state-of-art material, and the idea is to work on the balance of plant, first of all, in order to understand what are the real constraints given by the balance of plant to the operating car, to the operation condition of the car. And then, considering also the operating strategies. So what is the role, for example, of the battery itself? Are there any procedures that are needed to recover part of the performance that maybe I lost because of poisoning or other fuel cell-specific phenomena? So basically, after understanding the role of these constraints, the idea is to improve some components of the balance of plant and to invent or propose new system strategies, including hybridization, how to manage the water, liquid water or whatever, and the degradation also of the system. So this actually was should lead to a new condition when we have new overall constraints for sure, and so to provide this kind of improvement of the operation of the car by changing some of them. Here, confidential is just for fun, actually. Then this is basically the PhD activity, how will be done. I belong to the MRT Fuel Cell Lab. I'm a personal property of the MRT Fuel Cell Lab, where we have a long time testing and modeling of polymer fuel cells. And we also are going to start a new activity on battery testing and modeling. So we will give our contribution regarding the part of the fuel cell and the battery. Also, we found a collaboration with the Air Lab. They develop components for air conditioning, then test and model. And we think that they could give new ideas for the development of external humidifiers. And also, we will collaborate with the laboratory of fluid machines that have a large expertise on turbo machinery, so that we can develop a dynamic system modeling able to reproduce the real operation of a vehicle, including a fuel cell model that for sure will have all the physics that is needed for such an approach, the battery model, the humidifier model, that is a beginning, it will be for sure state-of-art humidifier based on membranes and so on, and later on we will explore different technologies. And then a compressor that will actually be developed in collaboration with the laboratory of fluid machines. Overall strategy will be needed. So the idea is then to have an improvement of the overall constraints that we can... how we can improve all the constraints of the car itself, and also how they could change in life, and so have a design of the system considering also that, for example, during lifetime, the cell efficiency will decrease, so we'll have a higher heat removal, and this could change all the constraints, for example, that we have during our lifetime. I think that's all for now, and thank you a lot.